Jerusalem, King David established our capital 3,000 years ago. In Jerusalem, King Solomon built our temple, which stood for many centuries. In Jerusalem, Jewish exiles from Babylon rebuilt the temple, which stood for many more centuries. In Jerusalem, the Maccabees rededicated that temple and restored Jewish sovereignty in this land. And it was here in Jerusalem, some 2,000 years later, that the soldiers of Israel spoke three immortal words, Har Habayit Bidenu, the Temple Mount is in our hands. Words that lifted the spirit of the entire nation. We are in Jerusalem and we are here to stay.
Jerusalem, 1968. Israel has just won control of East Jerusalem and the Old City. And now, the nation is digging. Beside the Temple Mount, laborers are unearthing walls and uncovering artifacts in one of the largest archaeological excavations in the history of Jerusalem. Leading the team is former Hebrew University President Benjamin Mazar. Over the next decade, Professor Mazar would uncover 8 acres of Jerusalem's past. And over the next 50 years, Professor Mazar and his granddaughter Eilat would uncover some of Jerusalem's most important history. Benjamin Mazar died in 1995, but his archaeological legacy continued. Today, two of Israel's most successful and acclaimed archaeologists are in Professor Mazar's family. Their findings, some of which are nearly 3,000 years old, connect Jerusalem today with some of the Bible's greatest kings and prophets. The Armstrong International Cultural Foundation in Edmond, Oklahoma, has a special connection to Dr. Eilat Mazar and to her grandfather. This connection goes all the way back to 1968 and to Herbert Armstrong. Herbert W. Armstrong was the pastor general of the Worldwide Church of God. He founded the popular World Tomorrow radio and television program, as well as the Plain Truth news magazine. Mr. Armstrong also founded Ambassador College and the Ambassador International Cultural Foundation. Mr. Armstrong loved Jerusalem and recognized the importance of its history to Israel and to humanity. In 1968, news of Professor Mazar's Temple Mount project reached Mr. Armstrong. He was immediately interested in the project, and before the year was out, Professor Mazar and Mr. Armstrong were friends. Professor Mazar and Hebrew University representatives formed a 50-50 joint partnership with Ambassador College. Meeting at the Presidential Palace to make the partnership official, Mr. Armstrong and Israeli President Zalman Shazar sealed the agreement on December 1, 1968. Not with a contract, but with a handshake. When Mr. Armstrong and Professor Mazar later met with Israeli leaders in the Knesset to discuss the project, Tourism Minister Moshe Kol called Ambassador College's partnership with Israel an iron bridge that can never be broken. Ambassador College immediately provided funding for Mazar's Temple Mount excavations, and over the years, hundreds of Ambassador students participated in the Big Dig. Meanwhile, Mr. Armstrong grew close to Israel's leaders, including Golda Meir, Yitzhak Rabin, Menachem Begin, and Shimon Peres. He developed an especially close relationship with Teddy Kollek, the longtime mayor of Jerusalem, and could often be seen strolling arm in arm through Jerusalem with either Mayor Kollek or with Professor Mazar. When Herbert Armstrong died in 1986, Professor Mazar praised Mr. Armstrong's deep devotion to the ideals of peace and justice in the spirit of the biblical prophets, and said that the name Herbert Armstrong would always be attached to this most important undertaking carried out in Jerusalem. Mr. Armstrong's successors rejected his teachings and legacy and ended the church's philanthropic efforts in Israel. In 1989, Gerald Flurry left the Worldwide Church of God and established the Philadelphia Church of God. In 1996, he established Armstrong International Cultural Foundation, and in 2001, he established Herbert W. Armstrong College. In 2005, thanks to generous donations from Roger and Susan Hertog, Dr. Eilat Mazar returned to dig in the City of David. Her objective was simple. She wanted to uncover the palace of King David himself. Success came quickly. Dr. Mazar and her team uncovered a structure that, based on its thickness and construction, in relationship to the stepped stone retaining wall structure below and other artifacts found at the site, was safely dated to around 1000 BC, the time of King David. In America, Gerald Flurry learned about Dr. Mazar's work and sought to rekindle the relationship and provide support. Dr. Mazar accepted Mr. Flurry's offer, and in 2006, after a 20-year hiatus, the ambassadors were back. Since 2006, Herbert W. Armstrong College has participated in all of Dr. Mazar's excavations. In 2007, Armstrong College was there when Dr. Mazar excavated a tower that was thought to be Hasmonean, but was actually part of the fortification built by the biblical figure Nehemiah. In 2008, Dr. Mazar, with help from Armstrong College volunteers, uncovered a clay seal belonging to a high-ranking official the Bible says persecuted the prophet Jeremiah. That year, they also discovered a 150-foot-long water tunnel that may have been the conduit King David's forces used in his initial conquest of the city. In 2009, the Mazar Armstrong team, thanks to generous donations from Daniel Mintz and Meredith Berkman, returned to the affair. During this phase, Dr. Mazar dated a large wall that was part of a royal complex built by King Solomon. This excavation also uncovered the bullae of King Hezekiah and Isaiah. In 2012 and 2013, the Mazar Armstrong team continued to excavate King Solomon's royal complex on the Eifel down to the First Temple period. From January 2012 to October 2015, Armstrong International Cultural Foundation was the first to exhibit the bullae of Jehuchal and Gedaliah, two Judean princes named in Jeremiah 38. In December 2015, Dr. Mazar announced that she had identified the original owner of another bulla, King Hezekiah. This was the first clay seal impression of a Judean king to ever surface in a documented excavation. In February 2018, Dr. Mazar announced another find that was uncovered during the same excavation, just a few yards from the Hezekiah seal. The partially damaged seal belonged to a man named Isaiah, and quite possibly, Isaiah the prophet. In January 2018, the Mazar Armstrong team began another excavation on the Eifel. This one funded entirely by the Armstrong International Cultural Foundation. Since 2005, Dr. Eilat Mazar has uncovered some truly sensational finds. Like her grandfather before her, Eilat Mazar today continues to resurrect Jerusalem's oldest, most important history. She has unearthed evidence proving that the Jews' ancient connection to this city is not a tradition or a myth, but a provable reality. The Armstrong International Cultural Foundation carries on the legacy of Herbert W. Armstrong. Today, we are honored to celebrate 50 years of collaboration with the Mazar family in the most important city in the world, Jerusalem.